go there. Let's make our escape. Come on, let's go there. What choice can we stay? Can you take me higher? Yeah. To a place where blind minds see. Can you take me higher? Yeah. To a place with golden streets.
I just want to say thank you to all my new subs and the subs that have been here since the very beginning. We started out getting 5 subs a video. Now we just got 50 on the last one, which is shattering records from all my previous videos. We used to get 6 likes. We just got 82. So I just want to take this time to appreciate you for sticking by me, joining me on this journey. I'm not sitting here to claim to be some guru that's going to get you $1 million overnight. I could, but I can never tell no lie. Only the truth will be told on this page. And I think that's what's drawing people in, because they're sick of getting lied to. They're sick of getting bent over a barrel and banged dry by the market and by all the liars and deceivers on StockTwits, iHub, and Twitter. You have to really pay attention to who you listen to, but the only person you should really be listening to is yourself. Do your own DD, do your own work, and everything will come to you. As much effort as you put in is as much success as you'll get out. So just keep that in mind, and thanks again for being here. So the reason why I chose to do maybe quite possibly, in fact, definitely the greatest band to ever exist on this planet, in this galaxy, in this universe, time frame, realm, state of existence, whatever you want to call it, were they sent by God? I'm not exactly sure, but that's what the legend says. Are they angels in men's clothing? I'm not sure, but that's what my father taught me at a very young age, and his father taught him. So I'm just going to go with the obvious. And they are the greatest to ever exist. But the reason why I chose them is because I think the OTC markets are about to go higher. This is a very good opportunity for volume to come in, which is exactly what I'm seeing. Everybody's coming in from the small caps, you know, your $2 to $5 to $10 range stocks that people trade because of the volatility. They're still a little bit safer than pink sheets, but they're not as boring as an Apple or a Google. They're not long holds as well. They're also swing trades. So people, a lot of the money that's coming out of that market is coming into the OTC markets. You can see it through the volume recently. And volume is what you need in the OTC to get through the dilution, to get through the issues. You have enough volume that can knock over the diluters, and then that's when you get runs. You need volume, and the OTC hasn't had volume for a very long time. You might get bursts. You might get pieces here and there, but it's not like back in 2020 when everything was just getting volume because of the influx of cash into circulation and what people were getting from the government for staying at home and eating chips and playing video games and smoking weed and drinking alcohol and not being able to go to the gym. But at least, hey, you got to avoid a cold that seemed to have just disappeared in the matter of a year. Now that we're focused on a war that we shouldn't even be in, let me stop. Let me get back to what I was talking about, and that's the fact that the OTC markets are boiling right now. You got a lot of volume coming in. Obviously, with the SVB scare, this has taken a lot of money out of the market, and that's for good reason. This is exactly what happened in 2007, last financial crisis, when the banks started to go under and they had to get bailed out. Well, that's exactly what we're seeing with SVB, and that puts that's very bearish. We're already in a bear market. Well, it just got a lot angrier, and it's going down a lot further, in my opinion. I've been saying this for a while, ever since COVID, that because we printed so much money and continue to do so for things that we don't even see as everyday Americans. That's why it's like taxes. It's like we put all this money into the system. We don't even see it. Then they just print more to dilute what we do have left down to literally nothing through extreme inflation, about to be hyperinflation. And then they act like taxes. No, dude, taxes shouldn't even be. They should be across the board 5%. That's all you need for roads and everything you need from the government. It's just unreal. I don't want to get into that side of it. I got to stay off politics, even though that's just common sense and everybody should care about the country they live in and the things around them. Like, I don't know why people don't tend to care about that. They just go to bread and circus with the NFL and the NBA and just watch people shoot hoops all day. Hey, there's a world spinning. Are you a part of it? Do you care about it? Do you want to live? Do you want to die? Do you want to speak Chinese? Do you like, I don't understand. It might just be denial, but either way, our economy is obviously getting destroyed, but at least you can still make money in some areas. So what I'm doing is I'm taking my money from those smaller caps that are getting annihilated. I'm shifting into the OTC. I'll ride this wave as long as it lasts. But when it calms down and the tide goes back out, then we move into something else. That's just what you have to do. You have to adapt to the situation. Where is the volume? Not only what stock is the volume in, what sector is the volume in? What level, is it pink sheets? Is it bigger boards? Is it, you know, what is it? That's what you have to figure out, and then you plan accordingly. It's not just winging money all over the place. You have to have a strategy and stick to it. So I'm making the adjustment to start going OTCs at least this week, and then I'll see where it is from there. But that's where I'm at. That's what I'm doing. It doesn't mean you have to. I'm just giving you observation of mine, because I pay attention to these things, and I noticed that OTCs are getting a little bit hot. All right, hopping into the charts now. We're gonna start with Mayo, whatever you want to call it. This thing looks like it's just wants to go. Like, it's trying to ride. It's separating itself from this middle band. Your technicals aren't overheated because of the steady increase instead of a huge spike. It just looks a lot like TRKA before it ran. I'm not saying that it's going to run to $1.40. I'm seeing that that is a possibility, which obviously isn't as much as TRKA ran. I'm just saying it's getting the same feel as far as stock twits and the boards. It's getting a lot of hype, a lot of interest, and that can always translate into a run. So play it accordingly, but just remember that volume needs to happen, and that it hasn't been happening recently. As soon as you see the volume come in, I think that's when this thing can really take off. When that's going to happen, that's anybody's guess. If I'm looking to enter, I think that a very, very good entry is around 70 cents. I think that if you can't have a chance to get in there, you're pretty good. I don't know if you're going to have that chance again, maybe, possibly, who knows. With small caps getting the beatdown that they have, I think that it's a very possible thing to happen. But if not, if you do get a bullish candle that engulfs these, it could start taking off. So keep your eye on it, set alerts, and play it accordingly. TPTW, this is the one that I loaded pretty heavy today. I bought 2 million shares at 17. I literally woke up at 12:50 my time. Market closes at 1 and it's an OTC, so I can't buy after hours. And I had 50,000 shares in it just because to track it. I had an alert set for a 15 break it or 16 break. It did. So that's why, you know, and my brain, I didn't have an alarm clock. My brain is just so engulfed in the market, which is what you have to do, that literally my body was like, yo, you're not going to check to see if anything's running right now before you, before the market closes. And if my body woke me up 10 minutes before, TPTW literally released news at 12:50. It's like I woke up to the news. Like, I heard them post it. I heard the CEO type it in. And luckily, I saw it. We closed above this middle band. Our RSI is not cooked. In fact, it's pressing into the hot zone, which is extremely bullish. The MACD is extremely bullish because it's not overbought. Your volume is there. Now, tomorrow, if there is dilution, I will play it according to that. If it stops at 2.5 and the volume starts to die down, I'll get out around there. If it hits that and pulls back to fill the gap, because I do think there's going to be a gap in the morning, then I'll think about re-entering. I don't know. It just depends on the amount of volume and if it's continued, and I'll play it however much the volume allows me to. But everything looks really good on the stock for tomorrow. BLLB. Uh, This one looks like it's wanting to go too. This was like a merger candidate back in the day. I don't know exactly what's happening with it right now. Maybe it's actually finally coming to fruition, but either way, you've had a lot of consolidation in this range. You've had a lot of spikes that have gotten rejected. Is this the one that finally goes? I'm not sure, but that's what they try and do a lot, is they want you to think that it's going to do this again and pull back, but then they might send it. Like I said, this is an OTC stock. If this gets the right amount of volume, I know that it's a very thin structure. Your volume isn't there yet, but it's coming in a little bit more. We'll see. It's just going to need to have continued volume because all of your other technicals are in pretty good shape. It does look like a good place to get in if it starts to run. Exol. This one also looks like it's flagging and it wants to take off. Again, these are all indicators that the OTC is coming back. Why? Because previously, we were having these runs and they would just dilute it right back down to here, dilute it right back down to here. But now these are riding these middle bands and they're showing signs of bullishness. I've seen this chart over and over and over again, and it's an ascending wedge and it's starting to try and break out of it. So we'll have to see. I'm not in love with the MACD. It is pretty high, but it's also came back down from all these high green bars. So you're kind of settling here. It's still a risky play to buy going into a breakout because I don't know when the volume is going to dissipate. But either way, I mean, if you're looking for a runner that has another chance, a chance at another leg, XOL could definitely be that play. Mara. This one bounced back up to that middle band. Again, a lot of consolidation in this range. Keep an eye on it. If it breaks above 9 with volume, you could be looking at a serious breakout. You still have a long way to go. That's almost 50% from here, about 35%. So you might even want to just grab it on this push. Maybe you get a pullback in the morning and you can get out at 9 and then reassess to see, okay, is it something that I want to rebuy, maybe on a pullback before it breaks that resistance? But still, like I said, that's 35% from the current price as the short-term highs that are now resistant. So we'll see what happens in that one, but keep your eyes on it. ONCS. This is one of those small caps that's actually making moves, and I really like the look of this chart. I told you that a couple of days ago that it seems to be leveling out here. Now it wants to break out. We have had a few false breakouts recently, so don't get too excited, but I would say that you're of a very, very strong chance, especially after a week of consolidation, a huge gap that they don't seem to want to fill yet. I think you're about to take another leg up, and you're looking at about 650. So if that's the case, I mean, you're breaking this previous resistance right here. As you can see, that horizontal line goes right around the top of this. So you're clearly at resistance. Let's see how it reacts. If it breaks above it, you could easily get in at 4 and out at 6. That's 50% gain. Don't get greedy. Don't think that in the middle of it that it's at 6 and you're like, no, it's gonna go to 9. It just play what you can, get the in between. You don't need to land on the moon with every trade you make. AWON. This one also looks very similar. These are all OTC stocks that are just showing bullishness today. This could easily break 6.4 and run. I would say the next stop would be over a penny. I mean, that would be the next leg all the way up here. I would say a penny is usually a psychological barrier. So you get in at 6, you sell 9, you get your 50%, and you exit. I'm just saying 50% instead of 30 because you might want to take advantage of the fact that OTCs are moving right now, and maybe you can clip it for a few more percentage points, 10x. X getting rejected at this middle band here. Volume's pretty heavy. Your RSI is oversold and your MACD is oversold, but turning up, which is a good sign. The volume is there. Like I said, if it breaks above this middle band, this could be a very, they, like I said, they usually try to stop people out. They get retail out of the stock before they send it. And that's look like what's happening here. Today, you had a day of consolidation right underneath there, right under that line. Let's see if it can break it. And if it does, you could fill this gap all the way up at 2, 216, whatever that is. And you're currently at 65. So this could be a big runner short term. We're going to have to keep our eyes close on this one as well for that gap fill at 215. DOMA. Been talking about this one for a while because of the fact that it looks like it wants to it was just oversold. I mean, you were all the way down here at support, which is like pretty much riding on this bottom for a while before it got sent. Well, it pulled back all the way to that, and now it's showing that it wants to kind of turn around. You almost have a fully engulfing bullish candle right next to these very steep drop. I think you're looking at the potential of 43 cents current price to get to 58 cents or somewhere in that range. That's a very good ROI. I think that this could be a bottom bouncer, dead cat bounce off that huge drop. HNRC. So hot in this helmet, man. I gotta put the air on. HNRC looks really good. I really gotta put the air on. HNRC looks really, really good. All right, we're back. But yeah, I really like this one as well. This is an OTC with catalysts in the pipeline. You know, once I'm definitely going to be taking gains from other stocks if I get them, and I'm going to be putting it into HNRC. I'm not even going to lie. I do not have a current position. I flipped it 11 to 13, and now it's starting to peak its head up all over this previous resistance already. It just looks really, 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 really good. This has a very long run potential in it. Your technicals look incredible. This one is a very thin stock and can run to 40 cents very quickly. And we're currently at like 13, so that could be a huge win for some people. Just make sure that you get out, because with these thin stocks, they can drop like a rock as well as run like a, I was going to say run like a rock, but run like a, can't think of anything. VS. This thing, you know, it looks like it wants to go again. There's not a lot of volume, but it is starting to like uptick, at least from this bottom. That's a big return from 50 cents all the way up to 80 some cents. And it wants to keep going. I think that this thing has the potential to form a W. You might get another run in this, maybe create like some, you might, because remember, this looks like it's not a big move, but that's almost 100% move from the lows. So just try to buy on that middle band. It's 75 cents and you're probably in good shape for a move. MGAM. MGAM looks good. Sorry. MGAM looks good with huge pullback, but now you're looking at like these small caps are so beaten down. If the market gets any type of relief, which I'm not saying that it will anytime soon, but if it does, it's not maybe going to go on a run like this, but you could get a pop back to this middle band, and you're currently at 67. So 67 to 96 is a very, very good return. That's basically 50%, and that's very good. So if you're buying down here, you're at a good entry. It's better to buy here and wait for the move than to buy into the run and get dumped on all the way back to the center of the earth. AMC. Sorry, guys, if I seem low energy today, I'm just like, it's been, ever since Wednesday, I've been working like 15-hour overnight, so tonight's my last night, and then I'll probably have off for a couple weeks, so we should be good to go. AMC, this one looks good. The pop, the drop, the pop, the drop, the pop, the drop. Now it looks like it might want to go again. You're getting this reversal candle after a bunch of straight red days. Again, if the market turns a little bit and gets some form of relief for the rest of this week, you could get a nice reversal, and you just trade this one. You get in it, you can see the ebbs and the flows that can be taken advantage of. So you get in here on the reversal and you get out when it goes up to $9 or somewhere around there. You don't get excited about it when it's high. You get really quick to sell. People tend to do the opposite. They buy the top, they sell the bottom. It's because that's what the market wants you to do. That's how they make their money. Civ B. I'm not even going to go over that chart because it's obviously, there's a whole nother ball game going on with that, but SMX, we'll do that next. Oh my God, it's hot. This thing is starting to turn down. You're oversold now, though. Is this going to create new lows? I don't know, but this is a very odd looking chart. It's like a handle that just fell off the cliff of the earth. But you know, this is a very thin stock. So if you do get a opportunity to get in low, you might be in good shape. We'll have to see. There's no way to really read this, but keep an eye on it. And if it gets like down to a dollar or something, it might be good for a bounce. PPCB. This one I did not have the best day, but as you can see, this thing is flagging. Boom, boom. It's getting tighter. The pennant is long enough where there's been enough consolidation in this range. Keep a close eye on this. If you're buying anywhere right around here, you're looking at a potential breakout to about 15, in my opinion, 14. And that's over a double from sixes. So if you buy it here and just wait a week or so, you might be able to double up in this bad boy. CDSG. Huge run now starting to pull back. It's not necessarily the trend has not been broken. As you can see, it's kind of riding this line. You do not want to break below 11, 11 cents. That seems like that's where the chart would start to break down at. If you do, you're looking at 7 to buy back in on an oversell or maybe even 6. But if you start scaling in at 7, you're in very good shape. This thing just is a little bit hot on your techs, clearly, and they're turning back down now. So we'll have to see what's going to happen. If they get news, that could change everything. There's always something that could change. That's why charting isn't always 100% a sure thing. But at the same time, you can use it as a tool. We'll have to see what material events follow up. We'll follow up with the material events on that one. This is Jizik. This thing has been getting absolutely demolished. It's down at 4.4, sub 4.4. This is a little bit oversold at this point, but could keep going lower. We'll have to keep our eyes on this one. I don't know what's going on with the company. I remember trading it back here when they were all the way at 4 cents. But look, this is why we don't hold. Some people probably did, and now they're all the way back down here. It's an issue. It's called a bag, and that's what we want to avoid at all costs. But you are getting to an oversold position, track it. PLPL. I wanted to get in this one today, but I just think it has another day, and I think TPTW is gonna run. I'm gonna use my TPTW money for this whenever I get in this. So this is currently at 5. I don't know if the ask got bought up at the end of the day, but this thing could definitely go. I think today was just a consolidation day. I think it does break 5 tomorrow and hit 6. If it does, you could be taken off to 10. I think the 10 would be the line of resistance. So if you can get in at 5, get out at 9, that's a big gain, folks. VDRM. VDRM, I would love for it to fill this gap. I'm not saying that it's going to. You're probably potentially going to stop down here on this drop at around 7.4. If you do break that, you could be headed to this gap fill at 5 or like 6. That's exactly where I'll buy. I'll set my alert there because if it does get sold off all the way back down to this gap fill, it will probably bounce the day after it fills, maybe even the same day. Set your alert there. It goes off. You have free cash. You enter and you don't think twice, because you know that that's a good position. And even write a note on your alert that this is a good time to buy. It's a gap fill. MWWC. This thing is, that's a bearish candle there. And this is why, you know, a subscriber of mine got in at 2 brilliantly, and he got out at 5, which is 150% increase. Absolutely incredible. You take that at all costs. You don't, now, yeah, did it go all the way up to 7? You probably couldn't have got out at 8. Probably could have got out at 7. Sure. But 150% on an overnight trade is, in my opinion, the best thing you could possibly do. If you hold any longer, you might get too sucked into the DD and the storyline, and you might forget to sell, and you might come all the way back down. So we're going to have to keep our eyes on this one. I don't really necessarily, I want to see another day to see where this goes. Now, remember, it did have a higher low, and it did have a higher high. And the OTC is hot. So I'm not saying that this isn't going to have another green candle one day after consolidation. I'm just saying I'm in a trip stock. I'm not going to chase a FOMO, because remember, if you're buying in at eight, let's say you bought in, you hit the ass today at eight, you're already back at six. You've already lost 25%. So, you know, if you get any more of a sell-off, and if it goes back down to four, you're all down 50%. So that's why you want to avoid chasing trips, because they can really bag you quickly. But every tick makes you a lot of money. So just make sure that you're picking your buys very, very carefully. GFAI. This thing is oversold to oblivion. I mean, I can't believe that but look, it's right down here. I mean, it finally filled this gap today, but it closed below the gap. But you're oversold now on your technicals. I mean, this thing is probably going to go through another bounce like this at least. I would just watch for another sell-off, wait for the market to turn a bit, and this might be good for a definite bounce. Maybe not going to make you 100%, but it could definitely make you 30%. EATO. Why do I know that it's not EATO? Whatever, I just can't do that one, I guess. Nut X. I mean, this thing is consolidated for a while. I don't see if there's a, make sure that whenever you give me a stock to review, if it's one that you personally want me to do, include what might be coming up in the pipeline as far as catalysts or whatever rumors are circling. Because as far as the chart goes, I'm not really seeing anything here. It's just kind of trading sideways for a good amount of time. Now, that's not a bad thing, but you are starting to break down a little bit. You don't want to get too far below this orange band, where it might come back all the way down to 50 cents. And you're currently at $1.34. So you just want to be careful that this is a false drop, and it does get a lot more strength. That's going to keep you going, because if you start to lose this line to the downside, which it's been rejected there a few times, tried to break above it, rejected it again. Now it's starting to show signs of weakness, but again, you keep it monitored and make sure that you're not falling too far below 134 or you're in trouble. Wall. So one of my subscribers said that he's like, I hope you hit this one today. I hope you found it. I mean, like, this would have been the biggest gamble of all time. We've already been seeing what's been going on with these things. I guess they're getting bailed out. That's probably why this thing has popped back up. I don't even know if it's a bank. I didn't do too much DD on it. Because this is like throwing your money in a slot machine. I mean, there's really no way to call this. Like, the people that say that they bought down at $5, $6, sure, they might have, but they probably threw $50 in on a gamble. This isn't the type of stock where you throw in 10 grand on a whim, because you could literally lose it all within seconds. Obviously, it did pay off for anybody that did happen to scoop up $9, $7, whatever it was. It had a huge return, 400% in a day. But again, that's like hitting a jackpot in a slot machine. And when people were buying that, they were actually not making the greatest decision, because I mean, think about if they had bought this dip. Think about if they had bought this dip. They just got lucky that they bought this dip, which, you know, hey, I mean, it was oversold. So I'm not saying that it wasn't a smart trade, obviously, in hindsight. But still, I mean, like, these type of, I don't play games with this. If I had a shit ton of money, yeah, I'd throw $2,000 in this, you know, to see what happens. But I'm not in the position to gamble right now. I have to keep my money moving up, because I have to be able to day trade. I've lost that ability. Moving and getting sued by my landlord cost me over $10,000. So it's just, I've been hit recently, but you get back up, you keep moving, and you make sure that your capital is secured at all costs. AMIH, AMIH. This one doesn't look bad. I mean, you know, it's not the greatest looking chart I've ever seen, but this is at a low, and it seems like it wants to start going again. You're going to need more volume to come in. You're going to need some type of catalyst to pop it. I'm not necessarily seeing anything right now that makes me, oh yeah, but it's still, you know, it's one to keep your eye on for sure. Cosm. This looks like a double bottom potentially. I think you have a few more days of consolidation in this range, and then I think you might form a W here. We'll have to see. I know that there's a lot of people interested in this stock. It did have a cult-like following when it ran back in the day. Unfortunately, they dumped it on everyone's brain like they usually do. Be careful of that because most of these are pumps and dumps, and they really live up to the name. But now is a good time to buy. That's why you buy in situations like this, not in situations like this. Unless you're day trading the momentum and you can get in and out real quick. Fours. This thing's getting volume, okay? So keep your eyes on this one. You get in at three or four, you just want it to break six, and then you could be off to 10. That's a very good ROI on the current price. Your MACD looks nothing overbought at all. Your RSI is actually pretty perfect, right above 50, which shows that it's getting hot. You're closing above this middle band 2 days in a row, 1 day of consolidation. As soon as volume comes in, this breaks six and runs to 10, in my opinion. OPGN. I think they got news today or something, and one of my Tommy, I think he was like pretty excited about it, but I guess they diluted on the news or something because it didn't really. I mean, it definitely no, it closed like 2% down, not a lot of action. So I don't know if news that did come out or not, but either way, it's starting to wake up here. It's starting to wake up. Your Bollinger Bands are pinching, and you're trying to close above this middle band, and your RSI is low, and your MACD is turning up, and your volume is starting to get a little bit higher. So you just need the volume to potentially fill this gap all the way at 462, held long enough that it's a definite possibility. But they don't always fill the gap, and if they do, you never know when they're going to do it. So it might be a waiting game for a little bit. Lunar, what happened in that one today? Had a red day, 10%, tough one. That's what I keep seeing is they get popped and then they're pulled back, but that's fine. That gives us a chance to re-enter if anybody goes in this. They had a huge pop. You should have sold it. Now you look to buy back. Is it going to keep this trend line? Not sure. Are you going to re-tap 10? Not sure. Is it going to form a W? We'll have to wait and see. This thing obviously can go on runs like no other. That thing ran like 1,000% in a couple days, I think even more. So it definitely has run potential. But with your volume increasing and not even near the type of spike, clearly this was caused by some type of dilution. So they're probably dumping just like every other company does, especially right now these days. But either way, we'll have to monitor that one to see if it keeps the trend line and keeps moving above 22 or 23. Pack V. Closed at 10. I mean, like one of my new subscribers said, he's like, keep an eye on this one because, it is a thin share structure, okay? The technicals are pretty much flatlined. You had a pretty solid day of volume today, but nowhere near where it needs to be. There needs to be a catalyst, but he did give some insight onto what's been going on with their financials that seem very bullish. If this thing gets news, it could run like a Dickens. So just keep your eye on it because I've seen this thing run before. I've traded this many a time, and it is a very low price. EPAS. This thing is pulling back, but again, you're watching this trend line right here. Is it going to keep that? It tried to bounce off of it. This is also support right here, which is keeping the trend line. Are you going to come back down to, God damn, this thing is itchy. 8-1, I'm not sure. You're a little bit overbought on your technicals. I hate to say it, but just keep. Is it going to do something like this again? Very possible before it takes the next leg. But I do think there will be a third leg in this one. I don't think it's just over for that. LRSV. By the way, EPAS and LRSV were both called by Dollars Only Club, who is, if you follow my Twitter, you'll see him commenting on or retweeting me a lot. He's a very good trader. He called CGRA, he called BMXI, he called LRSV, he called EPES, and I think he's starting to flip a little bit more often. I can't say that for sure, but I think he's starting to understand the game a little bit better in that aspect, maybe through talking with me. I'm not sure. I don't even know if he's flipping. I don't know what his... All I know is the guy's a really good trader. He picks winners. If you buy what he says, chances are you're going to make money. I'm not... This isn't a plug. He didn't pay me to say this. He always retweets my videos and tells people to follow me. So I appreciate him for doing that. I'm trying to show that. But it's not just, I'm not just blindly saying, because trust me, if he didn't have good picks, I wouldn't even say a word about it. But the guy really does know what he's talking about. He does find winners. So make sure you give him a follow on Twitter. LRSV looks, I mean, it still looks pretty stellar. You had this day of consolidation. Looks like it was going to fall down, but now it's picked back up a little bit. You just really need to get above a cent. That seems to be not only a psychological barrier, but also a barrier in the stock in the form of resistance. You get above that, you could be seeing blue skies here. People usually tend to go with these wicks as the highs. I don't know. I usually tend to go with the bodies, just because, especially since it's at one, it makes more sense to me to call that resistance. I think that if you do get continuation here, that's going to be a level to get past. You do, you're in good shape for a continued run. That about does it for me today. Again, I'll try and bring the energy next time, but I've been catching up on my sleep after working so many hours. And again, thank you to everybody that subscribed, that will subscribe. We're almost at 1,000, and I have the 4,000 watch hours way done. So is it going to be this video? I'm not sure. Let's try and make it this video. All I need is 26 more subs. Let's get it.